Praise the Lord, my friends. Welcome to the Power of Faith broadcast. I'm your host, Bishop Charles S. Waters. So honored that you took the time out to be with me today in the New Generation Ministries family. We really appreciate you. We love you. We thank God for you. Listen, I understand that God has a word for you. You must understand this is the season for miracles, signs, and great wonders. And no matter what the enemy may say, you are victorious in Jesus Christ. I'm going to say that one more time. You are victorious in Jesus Christ. The Lord has been tremendously moving here at New Generation Ministries. We've been on a subject series, Breaking the Financial Curse. And I'm telling you, it has been just enlightening to know that God has a plan for you and your finances. The Bible says, Paul says, I wish above all that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. So that means that God does not want you to be in poverty. He wants you to be in power and in the dominion and have financial increase and be above and beyond all of everybody even around you. God wants you as a believer to be the head and not the tail. And that's what we've been preaching and teaching on here at the Metroplex. I want you to come past and join me right here at New Generation Ministries, 3501 Brehms Lane. The address is on the bottom of your screen. I want you to come past. Let us know. Let me shake your hand at least. Let us know that these broadcasts has been a blessing to you. We would love to have you. Also, I want to encourage all of you wonderful pastors, ministers, elders, lay members. This is the season of strategic teaching. And the Lord has given to me a plan to be able to bring to the entire world. I want you to know that Dr. Charles S. Waters School of Ministry is open. Register today. Today is the time for you to register. I'm going to come back right after this little broadcast. I call it little because we don't have a lot of time. But I'm telling you, you're going to be blessed by what you see and the power of God that consumes this congregation. I want you to meet me here at the Metroplex. I'm going to let you watch this. Check it out. And I'll be right back to talk to you right after this.
Forget about your worries, leave your troubles on fear.
somewhere up in her hands. I don't know where this thing is going. Amen. Division, I believe. Amen. Come on, clap your hands for a minute, somebody. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord,
everybody. Praise the Lord, my kitties. I'm sorry, it was due to the buses, but I'm here, amen? We're going to turn it over to the MC. She can come on over.
Yeah!
Amen.
Yay.
Let's give praises to the kids.
Yay.
Let's help them lift up the name of Jesus, amen?
Amen.
And at this time, we're going to call Mira so she can sing the vision. Not sing it, but you know. Say the vision.
Yay.
And then
we're
going to turn it right over to the MC, amen?
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
It is our vision to build a multicultural, diverse ministry that can offer a place of refuge from your everyday life struggles. Not only a temporary escape from problems, but to build and prepare the people with a solution. Our purpose is to reach the lost, sinner, and backslider. Let them know there is a God who is merciful and just,
uh-huh.
who sent his only son to die for our sins so that we may be saved.
Uh-huh.
It is our mission to go to all the corners of the earth, teaching and preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ,
Amen.
Reaching the youth without compromising the life of true holiness, to visit the sick, troubled, and destroyed.
Come on.
Let them know that Jesus is the comforter, the way maker, and by his stripes we are healed. Here at New Generation Ministries, we want every single mother and father, every troubled child, every broken home to know there is a way out of your situation, and it's through Jesus Christ. For we are a chosen generation. Praise be to you now.
All right. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Okay, now we're going to have Kayla. Yeah.
For those of you that think that gospel music has gone too far, You think we've gotten too radical with our message? Well, I got news for you. You ain't heard nothing yet. And if you don't know, now you know. You know up in here. GP!
Everybody say stop. your parents in the Lord, for this is right.
Amen.
Honor thou father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise.
Amen.
That is made be well with thee and through thou mayest live longer on the earth.
Yeah.
And now we're going to have Kevin come sing a solo.
Amen.
All
right,
amen.
Son.
Amen.
Yeah, what's up? You coming tonight?
Going
tonight. Yeah, you know how we get down, yeah? But we're going to switch it up a little bit.
Switch it up a little bit.
Let's do this. Yeah, let the track hit and close to your veins. Chest get the popping like it's cordial for these things, son. Feet get the movement, man, of course it's a banger. Feeling in the streets, but the source ain't the same, son. Don't want some paint, but it's sort of like a changer. It's a bitch, you're getting caught up by a stranger. This is a girl, but you're caught up in the danger. Feeling what you need, you got caught up in the danger. You got a drastic part like a fast 400 in a track beat. I'm glad you got this Christ music on blast, cause you're not even here till you see them. Get jiggy if you like it. Let your hand on, cause you feel me in the mic. But I'm trying to find out if you really in the crush. I'm like, hold up, wait a second, homie. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Let me spread the news by the king and his judges, homie. Yeah, hold up, wait a second, homie. Yeah, hold up, wait a second, homie. Yeah. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Let me spread the news by the king and his legends, homie. Yeah, this ain't your everyday average. Delivery switch, but it's still the same passage. Price is our credit, means we're approved asses. Get rid of the weeds and see how green the grass is. I ain't tryna get spent like cash is. Beat my problems back to the clay like cash is. That's why I throw my arms up where the clap is. Rep God to the fellas, got the shoes where the gas is. Yo. Yeah, I'm tryna get loose. It's the fire in the bands. Let the dance be the proof. That's why I let the ground shake underneath the shoes. Let it sit and know it ain't nothing he can do. Yeah, I know you came to dance. When I get the chance, I'ma change my stance. Cause I'm influenced by Christ, never mask what I'm living. You ask why I'm different, I'ma ask all your question. You hold up, wait a second, homie.
Hold up, wait a second, homie. Hold up. Wait a second, homie, let me spread the news by the king and his judges, homie. Yeah, hold up, wait a second, homie. Yeah, hold up, wait a second, homie. Yeah, hold up, wait a second, homie. Let me spread the news by the king and his judges, homie.
Yeah, you ain't know who's gonna get down like this tonight.
Y'all
ain't
know how we gonna get down.
Yeah, hold on right here. Yeah, I told you I was gonna come to this party, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you come through? Where are you?
This new generation,
but
this
is how we come on through, and I'll show you how we do. Let's go. Body start rocking, everybody's moving. Christ is really on pumping in the music. Who is truth is a pump as I do this. His words are filled like ducks when I'm giving. So who's king do you claim to be? You gon' fire like the roof with the name and G. Light by the light like my socks for a fight. Right now I'm nice, live my life yelling Christ up. God's son trying to show you what he jumps at. His hand on my shoulders, temptation come back. Let me try to steal from me, but I hear a run back. Speed baby power, Satan buck, I'ma run back. I'd rather dig my way up with the shovel than I've lived on this earth and end up with the devil. I'm set apart from the rest, feel a spirit in your chest. But it starts with a yes. You hold up, wait a second, homie. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Let's go to New York, come on, get us, homie. Yeah. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Yeah. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Yeah. Hold up, wait a second, homie. Let me speak the news about the king and his legends, homie.
Yeah.
my bishop.
All right.
Hold y'all, wait a second, homie. Yeah. Come on, give God some praise in here. Come on, we can get real loud. Come on, give God some praise. Come on, each in the Metroplex, give God some praise. Thank God, like young people. Let's give God praise for all the young people in there so far. Amen. They did their thing. Amen. It is giving time in the house of the Lord.
Singing, and I told her I would introduce her, and you know, all that good stuff. And we just want to welcome everybody to New Generation's first youth service. The first one kind of rocky, but we're moving on from there. Amen. Amen. Come on, Princess.
I just want to thank the Lord for me being here today.
Amen. Let's go.
I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice, take joy.
Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Amen. Shall abide means to remain. dwell to stay.
Yes. Come on now.
Yeah. Take it down.
Under the shadow.
Yes, sir.
Means in his image, in his likeness, he will protect you, the Almighty God. Thank you and be blessed.
Amen. Amen. All right.
One of my little brother, Zion.
Oh. Yeah, Zion!
Zion!
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Zion!
They need some preaching.
Yeah.
We'll be reading Ephesians 6, verse 11.
All right. All right.
Go ahead.
All right, so take it time.
On the whole armor of God.
There you go.
He may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, against the ruler of darkness of the world, against spiritual wickedness in the place. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that he may be able to withstand in the evil days, and having done all to stand about with truth in heaven. The breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shall stand up the preparation of gospel and peace.
Yeah.
Above the all talking, the shield of faith. Dark of wicked, and the helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit.
Yeah.
Amen.
We have to put our work clothes on, the whole armor of God that protects life in the head.
Yeah.
If you put God first, your giants will fall. Yeah.
Yeah. All right, well.
Yeah. All right.
Love it.
Yeah.
You have to pray. Glory to God. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Bless his name.
Amen.
God in the name.
Amen.
Now we will have Stephanie come up.
I will be reading from Hebrews 11, verse 1 and verse 2.
Amen.
Now faith is substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Yeah.
Amen.
I believe that people should believe in God, in Jesus, so he'll make a way for all of his people.
Right.
Yeah, that's right.
What does believe mean?
Amen.
I know sometimes people say, like, I believe in you, or I believe in me, or I believe in you, but what about believing in
God? What does it mean
God?
To be framed by the, like, Jesus' word?
Amen.
To be framed is to mean you are framed by his word. Like,
you're so framed that you know the whole box is full of His words and what He said. If you were to go up to God and ask Him, the frame that I am in right now is that is what you said.
Right.
Yeah. He will tell you, yes, I said that, and that is how you get your answer. Like, you go up to God, God, did you write this? God, did you say this? God, did you say this to Peter? God, did you say this to a man? And things like that. That's what your frame is.
Yeah.
What is God's purpose? Like, why did God die for us?
Go ahead.
He could have kept His life for all of us, but if He did, we all wouldn't have been sitting here right now praising His name. We all wouldn't have been sitting here praising, shouting, screaming, hollering, doing all the type of things what the preacher says.
Yeah.
If God was not on this earth or up in heaven, we would never, ever live on this earth. Like, He had a mission, like, from His Father. He had a mission from His Father to save all the people, to die for our sins, just like superheroes. They have missions and things like that. If you were to fall, God would literally come from the sky and pick you up if you would never know. You would think that you're getting up by yourself, but honestly, if you don't feel it, you can feel God taking your arms and lifting you up. And He can be saying, I knew you wasn't in need, so I help you.
Amen.
Like in Tuesday, I pray to God that help me find my keys. So I go in my locker and my keys are right in my backpack. So while I'm going down the hallway, I'm just saying, thank you, Jesus. Because otherwise, I would have gotten in trouble for losing my keys. I would have been locked out of my house and everything like that. That's why I would praise God.
Yeah.
And just praise Him, man. I would just praise God until all of it is left out. I would praise God until I drop.
Yeah.
Why would Jesus create it? If Jesus wasn't created, like I said, we would never be on this God earth. Decided, let me have a son so I can conquer the world, or so He can help people with His life and things, help people with their lives. So He made Jesus, and Jesus was created.
Yeah.
Jesus didn't know that His Father told Him to do something, told Him to go on the mission, was to die.
And
luckily, I watched the movie of my grandma's, The Passion, and it kind of touched my heart to see that God was going all through that pain, but didn't actually give up.
Yeah.
He went all through the pain, but didn't give up. He died on a cross. He didn't say anything. He just died. And then the next morning, He woke up, and He raised from the dead, and we are still saved.
Yeah.
If He would never wake up, we still would have been saved. But from Him waking up, rising from the dead, it's like we should be praising Him for doing that.
Yeah.
Like, we should be praising God for all the hard work He did to save our sins.
Right.
I watched the devil look at Him, walking away, things like that. Like, the devil doesn't know that Jesus isn't afraid of Him. He beat Him. He did everything He could to stop Him. And what happened? When you're surrounded by the devil and he's trying to get to you, Jesus can see it. So He would literally come down there and fight the devil. Tell him, run away, get off, never come back to you. And then that's when you have a successful day. I was listening on the radio how the lady said she was having a bad day. Like, she got locked in her car and things like that. And while she was saying that, she was actually describing why Jesus said that. He said, I let you stay up there because there was some death angels, so I sent down my angels to fight them off. And so she slept late.
Yeah.
I left your cars and your keys because there was a drunk addict in this road and I didn't want you to get hit. That's actually Jesus saving your life, because if He didn't lock your keys in the car, you would have been like dead for that drunk driver just running.
Alright.
Okay, now we will have little Melvin come up.
Yes.
We're going to be reading from Psalms.
Uh-huh.
102. 102. Uh-huh. Chapter 1. Verse 1 and 2.
Okay.
Hear my prayer, Oh Lord, let me cry. Come into me. Find not the face. Find not that face. Through me. And the day when I am in trouble, incline my ear into me. In the day when I should call, answer me sweetly.
Amen.
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 I'm going to be talking about my dad, because they been in jail once.
Alright.
I still have a grandmother left. He took one of my grandmothers. She was fighting something, and he took her left.
Uh-huh.
And she...
Bless him, Lord.
Is old. I still have a grandmother left. She's 75 years old.
Yeah.
And still do things for me.
Amen. Yeah.
She never stops doing things. And two... I'll ride until I go away. When she go away, I'm not going to have no more grandmothers.
Bless the Lord.
Amazed. I'm just so excited because what they had, I challenged the kids. I didn't tell them what to do or how to say anything. I wanted to see what they had in them. Amen. And we from that, on that little bit that they did, we know they got a lot in them. And all we have to do is push them, encourage them, motivate them, and tell them keep on coming back and teaching them as well. Amen. Amen. This is a part of the service where we as adults, we want to encourage our kids. And we want a couple adults just to come up and encourage the kids at this time. It don't matter who you are, your mother or not a mother, we just want to encourage the kids. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Anybody want to come? Best time? Amen?
Amen.
Amen, church. I'm just so, can we give the children another hand? Yeah. I am just so, I'm so impressed. I am very impressed. You're singing, the dancing, the sermon. I am just so proud. I know I'm very
so
proud of the youth. It takes a lot to get up here in front of an audience, especially as a child, and to be able to sing a solo, to be able to read scripture, to be able to do a sermon. That takes a lot. And what I want to say is stick to it. Don't deter from it. Stick to your singing. Your voice belongs to God. Don't give it to anybody else. It does not belong to this world. Keep your voice for God. All the dancers, your dancing and your moves, it belongs to God. Keep it to God. Your scripture readings, things of that nature, keep reading the Bible. I'm telling you, once you keep reading and reading it, you'll get better and better. You'll speak better. You'll have more confidence. And nothing, and I mean nothing, not even Satan himself, will be able to come against you because you'll conquer everything. You all are amazing. You all are wonderful. You all are great. You are a child. You all are children of God. You are the heir to the inheritance. And tonight you made God proud because instead of being at home, getting ready for school, listening to whatever, doing whatever, you decided to be in the house of the Lord. And just like Minister White said, she let you all pick this. So this all came from your heart. And God sees that because God reads your heart. Not only your action, but he reads your heart. So I'm proud of you all. You all did amazing. I'm excited for the next one. I can't wait. I cannot wait to hear you sing again. Kirk Franklin over there in the corner. Hold up. Where DJ? Where Kevin go? Oh, man. El Kuja gone. No, Craig. But it was amazing. I'm very impressed. I'm very happy. I'm very excited for the next one. Keep it up. Praise, we got to have you up here next time, baby girl. But that's it. You guys, just keep going. Give them another round of applause.
Very anyone else? Amen. Come on, Deacon.
Right.
2 minutes, Deacon. Amen.
Now, what I'm supposed to do with 2 minutes? And y'all know I got all this stuff.
Make it work, make it
work. No, I just want to go off with what y'all say. I'm saying I really enjoyed everything y'all done. I am really proud of y'all. And standing here, I wish that I had what y'all had right now. I wish I had what y'all doing right now. I didn't have that. I would like for y'all to keep it going.
Right.
Stay positive. Surround yourself with positive people. You can do anything that you want to do, as y'all see here tonight. Y'all can do anything y'all put y'all mind to. Some of y'all walk around like y'all a little shy. But like I said, it takes a whole lot to get up here and hold this mic and perform in front of people. So just keep doing everything that y'all doing. Don't give up. This could be your stepping stone, and one day you too could be like me.
Amen. Andre, would you come and say something to the kids, please?
Amen.
The oldest youth.
Yes, the oldest youth. They've been here. We've been done. Amen. He's been here, and I thank God for the oldest.
Amen. Yeah,
it's
by example,
son.
I want to let y'all know that y'all really did pull it off tonight. Congratulations. Man, that little one right there, he took me somewhere, because when I seen him up here crying for his grandmother,
so it's like, at the end of the day, I started to think like, you can only live your life for yourself, you can't
worry about
it.
So that really empowered me to really want to be something in life. And now I have goals, ambitions.
Yeah.
I feel like college education. I'm determined to graduate, because nobody in my life have I ever known nobody in my family. So I'm determined to walk across that stage.
What? DeAndre. Yeah, I got you. Amen. Well, at this time, anybody else?
Yes, yeah, one more.
Melvin.
All right.
How about Deacon Melvin?
The way I thought it was.
Praise the Lord, sir.
Praise the Lord.
I just want to encourage all of y'all young kids. Y'all did a great job tonight.
Yeah.
Zion. Put on your whole armor, all your armor, keep
Amen.
It on.
Amen.
That was real good. And I wish all of y'all kids would do that. You know, it's really a blessing to see y'all in the church. And like I told y'all Sunday,
yes.
I love each and every one of y'all. All of y'all are special.
Amen.
If there's anything Deacon Melvin can do, please pull me up. Me and Deacon Bell talk about this all the time. He's with me. You know, we just want to help you guys. Anything.
Amen.
I don't care what it is. If you don't want to talk to your parents,
Amen.
Me and Deacon Bell know how to keep a secret. We've been keeping secrets for years. But seriously, I love each and every one of y'all, and I just want to encourage you to keep doing the right thing.
Yes.
Stay in school. Learn as much as you possibly can. And even when you get an adult, take your education further.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Because I was always taught, the more education, the more money. More education, the more money.
That's right.
So just stay encouraged and know that the church family love you all.
Yes, we do. Yeah.
Hey, the Lord says, we just want to, you must say, okay. And don't have us one that we're going to rock and roll
right.
When the baby's late for school the next day. Amen.
Amen.
First of all, I wasn't here, but I know y'all did a good job.
Amen.
Yes, they did. I know y'all did. Okay? And I want to encourage y'all, because I know how it is
to be in high school with peer pressure, in middle school, peer pressure, elementary school, peer pressure. I don't care how old you are going to go through it.
Yes.
As a Christian, you have to walk the walk and talk the talk.
Yes.
You cannot let nobody turn you around.
That's right. That's right.
Because they will try.
Yes.
That's right.
Been there, done that.
Yeah.
So I'm here to let you know, keep your head up.
Keep it up.
And depend and lean on God always. No matter what you go through, lean and depend on God.
Yes.
He's the only one that can bring you through.
Yes.
All right?
Yes.
I love y'all. Can we stand up and give the kids one more round of applause?
Yeah.
Let's give it up for the kids of New Generation. Amen. We about to close this out, and we will let our bishop say the last words. And I'm just so happy. I'm floored. I'm just amazed. I can't wait to go home and get a report to my husband. He wanted to be here. Y'all heard from him Sunday. He'll be encouraging each one of y'all one by one. But I just encourage every last one of y'all to keep striving. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Come on, let's give God praise. Listen, let's give God for Minister White. Amen. 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 Come on, give God praise to her. Amen. Thank God for her. Amen. Thank God for all of you wonderful parents. If I could say anything, and we'll be dismissed, and then we have to go and get your kids ready for school tomorrow. It's been a tedious time.
Yes.
We're gonna make money. Get your clothes out now. You know, you buck sergeant. but if I could say anything, parents, just keep encouraging your kids. Please keep encouraging your children. You know, I thank God for my parents, amen. They are here with me in ministry, amen. Thank God for them, amen. It's very rare you see that. Very rare you see that. Thank God for the first lady of this house. Thank God for her as she lead, amen, our kids. And one thing we try to teach our kids, well, not try, we do, we teach them how to be respectful and how to honor. And I know sometimes your kids can be a little outlier. You know, you gotta check them a little bit here and there. Amen. But you know what really got me the most tonight, and we're gonna pray out. I think what got me the most tonight is sometimes as parents and as adults, you know, when we in worship, you know, we do our thing, and you see the kids praying, playing, but you never would think the whole time they really taking it in. You see what I'm saying? I learned, amen, that your kids are soaking in. There you go, amen. 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 We thank God for the kids. Amen. Yes, yes. While we pray for our young people, amen. Young people, y'all holding your neighbor's hand. Amen. And parents, I want you just to pray along with me tonight, all right? Father, we thank you for your grace, your mercy. We thank you, God, for these young people. We thank you, God, for what you're doing in their lives. God, we acknowledge your presence in this place tonight. Father, bless each and every one of these young people. Give them their heart's desire. They will not be a statistic. But Father, the favor of your presence is on them. Father, we thank God for each and every one of them. Father, as we pray for them and we lay our hands upon them, anoint them to be great success stories. Father, we thank you for great success in their everyday life. Father, like natural, like spiritual, God, we thank you, God, for harvest. We thank you, God, for favor in their lives. We thank you, God, that you will honor this prayer tonight, that you will honor them to be great and be wonderful and be marvelous. We thank you, God, for them, Father, because this is the hour of transformation for them. Father, we pray, even while they are in school, you will have a hedge of protection around them. Father, so much murder is in the land. So many people are shooting innocent people.
God bless you, friends. I'm thankful that you got the opportunity to tune into the Power of Faith broadcast. I'm sure what you heard in this sanctuary just blessed you tremendously. And I want you to make sure to be with us. Listen, every Tuesday night at 7 p.m., right here is Kingdom Building Bible Study at the Metroplex. That's Kingdom Building Bible Study. And that's at 7 p.m. You will be empowered and consumed by the Word of God that we're bringing forth to you every week to encourage you and empower you to be more. Every Thursday night we have Thursday night services at 7 p.m. And this is called Thursday Night Fire. You do not want to miss it. God really moves tremendously in those services as well. Sunday morning, high praise, high worship, 11 a.m., where you can receive a word from God like none other. And also every second and fourth Sunday at 5 p.m., for all of you who've been just looking for God to heal and deliver, this is your great opportunity. At 5 p.m. every second and fourth Sunday, we are having healing and deliverance services here. Again, that's healing services. Now, I know because we're living in the 21st century that oftentimes a lot of churches and people have done away with the old-time religion. But it was the cross, it was the religion, and the anointing of our ancestors, not just black or African American, not just white, but from all denominations, all races, came together. And there was a shifting, there was a power of God moving, just like the day of Pentecost. It happens here at the Metroplex on a daily basis. You need to mark your calendar, mark your schedule to be here on those Sunday evening services. But I want you to join us. You know, friends, God has just really been awesome. He's been good. And I want you to know that God has us in the right place at the right time. You are in the right place at the right time to receive a miracle. I'm going to say it again. You are at the right place at the right time to receive a miracle from God. But I'm telling you, this is your season. Come to the house. Be blessed here at New Generation Ministries. Again, 3501 Brehms Lane. That's 3501 Brehms Lane, Baltimore, Maryland, 21213. Or call us, 410-779-8299. Let me know that you really enjoy the broadcast. If you want to know different ways how to support the broadcast, give us a call or write us. Write us your prayer request. We'd love to hear from you. But remember, what you say today determines the future of your tomorrow. And I'm telling you, this is your season, your opportunity to be blessed. I want you to register right now. Register now for the Dr. Charles S. Waters School of Ministry. Classes are forming. People are excited. You need to be here. Until next time, I'm your host, Bishop Charles S. Waters. Let's stay connected. Be in good faith. And I'll see you next time.